Good morning and happy hump day to you. Happy hump day. It's another hump day, happy chat. yay. Good morning and happy hump day to you. It is another Wednesday morning. Yay. Do you like Wednesdays as much as I do? I really love them. Welcome to the Wednesday morning hump day happy chat with yours truly. It's Valerie Shepherd coming to you live from the Hartley Center for Mindfulness and Self-Mastery. And here it is blowing up a gale outside. I want to take a couple short moments to send out thoughts and prayers for all those touched by the fires here in California. And all those anywhere around the world where there is natural and unnatural disaster that's threatening life and limb and property and safety and all of that. It's scary. I've come to close to fires once or twice. It is a scary bit of business, let me tell you. Scary. And it's amazing how close they can get and then all of a sudden completely change direction. Or the converse, how far away they can be, and then all of a sudden, quickly change direction. The wind has things blowing around my porch, and my chimes are going crazy, and it is just an incredible experience of the force of nature, the force of nature. And it reminds me of the force within me when I remember my oneness with all that is and my oneness with nature. It's pretty powerful. It's pretty magnificent. So happy Wednesday. Thank you for joining me. Hello out there. Thank you for joining me. We're talking today on the 30th, which is the day before Halloween. And we're coming to the end of my magical birthday month when I'll be doing finishing up my month of birthday celebration. And I've done a little bit too much of the eating kind of birthday celebration. So between now and Thanksgiving, I'll be doing a lot more working out to try and, to take charge and correct the situation that I've created during my celebration month. Well, here we are. And it's a hump day happy chat. Here's what we're going to be talking about today. So hump day happy chat is about really how do we help you create the kind of happiness that you want through something that I teach called self-mastery. And the definition of self-mastery is mastering you in your life so that you can exquisitely manage whatever your life brings your way. And I teach this from this perspective. Good morning. I teach this from the perspective that our lives are happening for us, not really to us. They're at any given moment giving me, my life is giving me an opportunity to claim that which I want, to release that which I don't. And it's a constant cycle, right? Like the cycle of reciprocity, the ebb and flow of life, giving and receiving, accepting and releasing. All of those things are like the dance. And the title of my book, the subtitle is Dancing Your Soul, S-O-U-L, Light Style. Light style meaning releasing yourself from the things that don't serve you so that you can soar, as I say. This is how you soar. You get rid of the anchors that weigh you down. And so these hump day happy chats are weekly opportunities for me to answer some questions that people have sent me, talk about some things that my students often bring to me, and just bring topics to light and life that can help you have more happiness, fulfillment, inner peace, and success. Yay. I'll take more of all of the above. Happiness, fulfillment, inner peace, and success. So I really want to talk about something that's about to happen. We're right on the verge of it happening, which is the annual celebration of Halloween. Halloween. Where did it come from? Why do we do it? What's so important about it? So today's Hump Day Happy Chat is about life lessons from Halloween. Yeah, you thought it was all about the candy, didn't you? So, according to history.com, The tradition of Halloween originated back in ancient times with the Celts. It was actually a Celtic spiritual festival called sow-win. Sow-win, spelled exactly like it sounds, S-A-M-H-A-I-N. That's not how it sounds. Sow-win, spelled Samhain. It's a Gaelic word, so it doesn't follow. It's a different language, so it's not pronounced the way we might think it is by just looking at how the letters and the phonetics might fall. So sow-win, the Gaelic word for this Celtic festival. It's sow-win was a festival that marked this period kind of at the end of October and beginning of November, which was when the harvest was being brought in, when things like there were beliefs that the barrier separating the physical world and the spiritual world would break down during this festival, allowing more interaction between humans and spirits and denizens of the quote other world. It was celebrated then at the same time as it is now, end of October, beginning of November. And it was about welcoming in the harvest and preparing for what was known as the dark half of the year. The dark half of the year, meaning the days are shorter, things are, the light changes in the different seasons. And so it was considered darker, like when people were getting up and bringing in the harvest and coming in the evening, it was just dark. And so in the 8th century, though, so when kind of changed a little bit from being that 3 or 2 day celebration, when Pope Gregory III decided to declare November 1st as All Saints Day, and then October 31st became All Hallows Eve, because it was the eve of this hallowed day of celebration of the saints. And over time, it's just evolved into this thing is called Halloween. In some places, it's called All Saints, All Hallows Eve still. And it's further evolved from being this day of recognition, getting prepared for the Saints Day, to all the kinds of stuff that we're used to doing probably here in the West. Activities like trick-or-treating, carving jack-o'-lanterns, festive gatherings, parties, costumes, treats, all of that. So what's the big deal? So now that we're kind of on the same page with where this came from, I love looking at the origin of words and why are we celebrating Halloween, right? It's never been my favorite holiday, which is interesting. It's just not something that I'm really excited about all the time. But I know friends, I mean, in my neighborhood, people's houses have been decorated for Halloween since October 1st. It's kind of like when you go shopping at the beginning of the fall and they've got all the Christmas decorations out. So it's kind of the same way in my neighborhood and for some of the families near me, really big Halloweenites, Halloween celebrants. So what lessons do we get from Halloween? And I think there are a few. I'm going to go over a couple here, four. So one, that getting dressed up. And I dress up sort of the same way all the time. And I like dressing up as plays on words. I won't tell you what mine are because next time you see me in a costume, you'll be able to guess. But I like plays on words rather than a particular person or something like that. Although one year I did go with a couple girlfriends as Apollonia 6. Yes, big Prince fan. We went as Apollonia 6. You have to look that up if you don't know who we were. So anyway, dressing up, getting dressed for a situation. So you could think about that in non-Halloween terms as dressing up, suiting up so that you're ready for the situation. I think of it as getting my game face on. How do I get my game face on? And so what does game phasing have to do with happiness? So I've noticed in myself, we've talked about it, a couple happy chats. You can go back and look at the one on the warring self versus the infinite self. So the game face that I put on sometimes, and maybe this is you in some way, shape, or form, the game face that I put on sometimes is the preparing for battle face. It's the face that says, from the mental mind and maybe the wounded heart, that there are people and situations and things and forces against me. And with those things out there, I have to be steeled for victory. I have to be protective. I have to protect my heart, close down a little bit. I'm not able to receive. I have to be constantly thinking and analyzing so that I can be safe, so I can feel safe. And so the safety of the situation is paramount when I'm suited up as my warrior self. And so the questions that you would ask in order to be in the space for more joy, right? In the Hump Day Happy Chat, it's how do we see the situation in the life the way it is while we go about creating what we really want in those moments? So if I notice, or when I notice, that my warring self has come all prepared for battle, I take a couple deep breaths, and you'll probably hear this as a recurring theme in all of the Hump Day Happy Chats. There's so much data on how just coming back to the breath brings the self into alignment with the self. You get a chance to actually hear what's going on in here, and I'm less likely to do the knee-jerk reaction that is driven by fear. The opposite of love is not hate. The opposite of love is fear. Anger and hate and territorialness and all of that is all driven by fear, which is the absence of love. And so on Halloween, where there's some kind of fun kind of fear, right? A little bit of fear goes a long way on this thing called Halloween. Noticing when I'm suiting up for something that isn't playful and fun, when the suit that I'm wearing, when the costume that I'm wearing is about the false self. It's about protecting me from what I might be afraid of, and that might be conditioned as a pattern of fear, not necessarily true in the present moment. So that's dressing up. What about going around asking for treats? Knocking on doors and saying, trick or treat, loudly, holding out your bag, waiting for something to be thrown in it, or sometimes a pillowcase. Waiting for something to be thrown in, sometimes a plastic pumpkin. And sometimes you can reach in, take the treats, and other times, you know, when I went trick-or-treating, they were given to you. You didn't reach in. And what about when you went to those houses and they had the worst candy? You're like, oh, don't go to that house. They always have the ones you didn't like, whatever those were. Or they had no candy, they gave apples. Here's a bag of grapes. That was not fun. The question, though, becomes in this game of what lessons can we learn from trick-or-treating, from the treats, can we maybe accept everything in gratitude and fullness and openness as the treat that it is, or the treat, the energy of the treat with which it was given? Can I just receive it as, oh, yay, 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 goody, 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 Hercules, Hercules. Can I just receive it like that? Yay, yay, yay. That was another movie reference. Look it up. Yay, yay, yay. Can I receive it in that energy, even when I get what isn't exactly what I want? Can I receive it in joyful fullness, even as I notice there's a contrast, what I want, what I don't, what I want, what I don't? Or what I want more than what I got, right? Doesn't have to be either or. It could be, I like it and I wanted this. Can you still stay in joyful, happy, yay, thank you so much, candy, yay, and still go for what you truly want in the midst of that experience of maybe less than what you really were hoping for? That's the way you get it, right? It's not a matter of can you, it's a matter of get about being that, because that's how you actually get what you want. You don't create as a co-creator in the universe what you want by focusing on what you don't. You create it through law of attraction, law of reflection, law of karma, law of reciprocity. You create it through doubling down on what you do, even while what you don't is there to show you the contrast, just to remind you, not to make you upset, not to make you feel like the universe doesn't know you, doesn't see you, doesn't understand you, doesn't love you, doesn't want to support you. The universe is giving you one answer at all times. It's yes. I'm looking for my yes banner. I don't see it. It's usually sitting right next to me. I'm missing it. It's a yes. Yes, yes, yes is the answer that the universe is giving you at all times. So the question is, are you asking the right question? Be focused on what you want, not on what you don't. Then, what if you get a trick? How many times have you got a trick? Like someone plays a practical joke on you, or there's a trick somehow. It feels like tricks are happening around you and people are tricking you. Is there a way for you to experience it as part of the game of life, your game in your life, and not take it personally, not become wounded? Feeling that others are against you will certainly rob you of your happiness in any moment, in any relationship, any situation. Believing that the cards are stacked against you, that people are going to pull the rug out from under you, that the universe doesn't have your back. That's going to create stress, anxiety, worry, fear, and all kinds of other ways of acting out that may put you in separation from, further separation from the relationships and the things that you're really wanting to attract. So can you stay in the energy of, this was interesting and it's not necessarily personal. I didn't like that. And maybe you can share that. Boy, I really, really, really love it to be like this next time. And if it's not able to be created that way, move on to way it can be created. But stay in the high vibration, stay in the high vibration, the highest vibrations that you can. Tolerance, compassion, receiving, joy, peace, harmony. And then the last one for this chat, hump day, happy chat. The last one was that Celtic celebration of sow-win, where the people in ancient times believed that at this particular time of year, the barriers between the physical world and the spiritual world break down. Now, what they were concerned about was people from the netherworld coming and taking their babies and their prosperity and their jewels and things like that and taking them back to the underworld or the netherworld, the other world, so to speak. That's not exactly what I'm talking about. This idea that I'm talking about is the spirit world being alive and rich and around us at all times. And that scientists are even proving this, y'all, that there are multiple dimensions happening at the same time. Think about that. That you could, as a part of this hump day happiness, like figuring out your happiness, close the gap between your spiritual self and your human self, that's called raising your consciousness. Close that gap, live as an integrated spiritual human person, and create from a higher vantage point, viewpoint, a higher perspective, create from a higher endowed and integrated power, create with a higher deeper, richer, endowed knowingness. All of that. Talk to the plants and the fairies. Like I think Guardians of the Galaxy and the Lord of the Rings got it right. Remember Groot, a tree being, talking, moving, saving the universe. And in the Lord of the Rings, the tree people that carried the little people, like, that is the truth, that they're living beings that we have a way of connecting with. Yeah, see, little exclamation point on my thought. Woohoo! It's like, it's about this. Believing in you, believing in the spiritual nature of you, believing in the wholeness of you, in the dynamics of the universe that make you able. Oops, something fell over on my deck in all the wind, that you are able to kind of transmute this dense experience of the third dimension called Earth and rise and experience other planes at the same time. Like one of my fervent prayers right now is take me to the dimension where the answers are already unfolding. My answers are already unfolding. So rather than lament that right now I don't know what's coming next, or that right now there may not be enough of this or enough of that, or that right now a person's not here when I want them here, or a person's here when I don't want them here, right? I talk about to myself, where is that plane, right? The space where the spirit world and the physical world are coming together and the answers have already unfolded. Wow. Yes, 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 yes. So the idea in this last question of these worlds coming together and that you are bigger than your human self is to claim your oneness at all times so that you can access these broader opportunities that are unfolding in every single moment for your joy, your peace, your fullness, your fulfillment. Yay! Thank you for joining. Please hit the share button and spread this joy with other people. There are probably one or two people where you're hanging out who could use a different perspective on what's going on in their lives. And I would love for this to be something that supports them to get that different perspective and to spiral up and claim more peace, love, joy, and freedom. So again, I'm Valerie Shepherd. Thank you for joining me on this another edition of the Hump Day Happy Chat, coming to you from the Hartley Center for Mindfulness and Self-Mastery. And I always like to close with the prayer of loving kindness from the Buddha. May all beings be peaceful. May all beings be safe. May all beings be happy. May all beings awaken to the light of their true nature, and may all beings be free. And remember, all beings includes you and me. Stay well and be happy. Signing off of the Hump Day Happy Chat. See you next time. Button, button, find the button. Bye now.